And sometimes God will test you. Amen. And cause you to stretch. I remember, amen, praise God. He's not trying to stress you. He's trying to stretch you. Uh-huh. And amen, praise God. I know what the word of God on today, amen, is coming to stretch you. Now, I don't know about you. You might need to dip yourself a little bit more oil so you don't pop under pressure. Amen. So get that Holy Ghost oil, amen, and dip yourself so when that word comes in and it's an hallelujah, you don't pop on me. But you stay together, you hold it all together. Can I get a witness? Come on and receive you, the man of God, in this hour. Amen. Dr. James Pendergrass, amen. Apostle, we thank you for blessing the house. Let's bless the name of the Lord in this place. Let's continue to bless the name of the Lord in this place. Isn't God awesome? Isn't God awesome? Isn't God wonderful? Has God been good to anybody? Over the course of this morning, over the course of this week, over the course of this month, has God been good to anybody? Does anybody in here have a relationship with God? Oh my God, the first thing that came to mind as I heard the Holy Spirit speaking a few moments ago was how Peter stepped out of the boat and he began to walk on the water. Yeah, and the pastor was talking about a wave coming in. I believe that Peter was walking on a wave. When Peter walked on a wave, he ended up running into the very thing that would carry him back to the ship. Can I tell somebody that it's the ship that's going to help you? It is the relationship that is going to help you. Relation, can you relate to the ship? Can you relate to the thing that's going to take you to the next place? Relation, ship.
Does not fall, there is no progression. But because there is revelation in this place, because there is word in this place, I perceive movement. Because where the word of God is, there is movement. That means that the people are not caught into a stagnant place where they can't move and go into greater things. So, by the word of the revelation that is coming forth on this morning, I perceive a move in the spirit. The Lord sent me down here on this morning to talk about being mission-minded. Because the people of God have to be on the move. And in order to be on the move, you have to have a mission. You have to have something to go after. You have to go and fight for something. You have no right to anything that you have not pursued. So that means that you have something worth fighting for. Can we pause for a second? Because even though the world may consider this somewhat unorthodox and way out of season because we're in December right now, I'm going to talk about something that happened in the month of September.